has always been the main influence over my life ever since I can remember. Growing up, listening to my mom and pops, you know what I'm saying? Play old Mary J. Blige, Casey, and JoJo, you know what I'm saying? From that to the Wu-Tang Clan to, you know what I'm saying? Everything on the East Coast, right? Pops are from Brooklyn, my mom's from, you know what I'm saying, Los Angeles. So I just got so many influences growing up. Music that, you know, it's just kind of been embedded in me, you know what I'm saying, ever since the very beginning. Music has always been a way that I've known how to express myself. Singing around the house, singing at weddings, funerals, school choir, just life in general. I would say my sound, for lack of a better way of expressing it, R&B. You know what I'm saying? I just make music. Like I said, I listen to all types of music. I listen to everything, really. So my ears is a lot different than most people. I write and produce my own music, but I know how I want my music to sound. Which is a lot of artists can't say. If me and Mike were best friends, I would literally have his voice on half of all my beats. Because he's a beatboxer, like a lot of people don't know that. Now, Alive. Of course, I would work with Drake. I would work with Jay. There's a bunch of people out there I would work with. I would work with everybody, really. I started writing my own music around 2008. It's when I kind of really stepped out of the role of just being, oh, my son is a singer, performer, he's gonna get on stage and he's gonna do his thing. And now really just being more interested in the actual creative process. What makes people like a song? What makes a song stay in a person's head all day and they can't stop singing it? Saying, and you know, I started asking those questions, and it just took me on a journey. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't work. Like, I engineer my own sessions, I write my own music, produce. Like, I literally sometimes I don't even really need anybody to do what I do. And a lot of that music is a music that people go to my SoundCloud, go to my YouTube, or whatever. That's the music that they're hearing. I think when you write, it always comes from your heart. I think how it comes together is always different. It's always different when it comes from your heart. Let me rephrase that. It's always different when it comes from your heart, because a lot of times people try to think their way through a song, and then you listen back to the song and you say, well, that sounds real, like, extra thought out. You know what I'm saying? And then you got those songs that just hit you. The moment that they come on, that's how you know it came from my heart, because it was real. Besides singing, I play guitar, keys, like I said, I produce, clarinet.
Two.
I actually had to learn clarinet on a TV show. Like, I didn't even learn that. Like, I wanted to just pick it up and learn it. Episode of Lincoln Heights. A lot of people don't know I was on a TV show called Lincoln Heights for 4 seasons. Probably don't get to see it. I played clarinet in one of the episodes, and I literally had to learn for like 2 weeks how to play the clarinet. Which is really cool. express through my music and everything that I do is I want whatever that I do to make the world better.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So somebody took a message or something that I've been through and learned from it, applied it to their life. Somebody loves somebody because I love a particular person in a song. Take it and make the world better. Because it's all in the sense. Like, I could sit here and be an asshole to you right now. You know what I'm saying? This interview just got completely terrible. But I'm just the type of person, I have a good heart. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to spread good energy. I want to enjoy everything that I do. I think the message and your image go in. Because if you're saying, if you're going around telling the world, what's a good analogy for this? If you're going around telling the world, I only like dark skin women, love dark skin women. And then you go out into the world, and all you're ever seeing with is light skin women or white women. Anything but a dark skin, people are going to begin to be like, this is not the same guy that I like from his music. You can't. That's how a lot of people realize you really have to be true to who you are out here. It's very, very important. My goal with my project, The Truth, it's really to kind of just give people a perspective of where I'm at in life right now. And also showing people that I've learned a lot, I've grown a lot. Being in the music industry, being a young entertainer, and you know, just being a part of that young life, you know what I'm saying? And just growing up, really just seeing things from the perspective of a young man and what my journey looks like and the things that I've learned, the lessons that I've learned, you know, all these different things, it's just all combined into one project. And so far, it's just been amazing responses. So I'm really excited for everybody to hear the full project coming soon. Truth, y'all be on the lookout. It's gonna be crazy. I get inspiration from so many places. I think my main inspiration comes from God. Another huge form of inspiration for me would be just seeing my family happy. Because I just see them going through so much while I'm out here. Yeah, I go through stuff too, but at the same time, it's like, you know, you always want to see your family doing really, really good, better than you, better than everyone. So that's definitely one of the inspirations behind me telling the truth. Like, my song, The Truth, I go and say it at the end of the second verse, like, throw my mama a minute, because she quit her career to make sure I was filming. My mother literally quit her career downtown Los Angeles as a paralegal to take me to and from set every single day so I can film and develop my career as an actor. On screen, a lot of people don't know that, but that's a huge sacrifice that she did. You know what I mean? So, I'm just here to just do the work of the vision that I see. And it's happening. I know that it's going to complete itself. One of my main inspirations. really talk a lot about my family. But I guess in this new phase of my career, the truth, shedding a little bit more light on my life. I'm one of four. There's four of us. I got an older brother who's 15 years old. He's 24. My little brother just turned 17. Balling. Just won CIF championship. Him and his team, shout out Diamond Ranch. Shout out to y'all name. Keep going hard, Panthers. My little sister is just growing up. Back in California, I don't get to see them all the time, but when I do, we have a lot of fun. What would be the most valuable lesson I've learned in this industry? Oh man, I could say one of the most valuable lessons that I've learned in this industry is really to, it's a game. You have to understand that it's a game. It's like any industry, really. It's all one and the same. You have to know how to play chess. So you have to know when you can relax. You have to know when you can't relax. You have to know. You just have to be on your P's and Q's about so many things. Otherwise, you know, the stars will align. And unfortunately, that's what happens to most. Artists, specifically, is they'll get content with, oh, I recorded 50 songs, so now I don't need to stay in the studio no more. Now I just need to just go out every day so that people can see my face. Stay recording. Like I said, it's a bunch of lessons. I can sit here all day and talk, but I definitely want to drop those jokes. I'm focused on more acting right now. I got a couple big things on the table as far as big screen. Some independent stuff that I have in the works. Definitely on the acting side and heavy still right now. I'd love to get into fashion. I mean, what am I doing right now? You know? It's all about entertainment. It's all about just doing what everybody else thinks you can do, or doing what they just simply can't do. Definitely want y'all to know that I appreciate the continued support, continued love. Let's keep spreading the word, the truth. If y'all haven't checked out none of my new music, go to my SoundCloud right now, soundcloud.com/officialmyshine. It's M-I-S-H-O-N.